and defending. And surely his goodness and mercy here daily
to the Lord God Almighty. Good morning, everyone. We bless the name of our Lord and our God. Yes, Lord, you are our God, you are our Lord. Hallelujah to your name, Lord. Yours is the greatness, yours is the power, glory, victory, and majesty. Yes, Father Lord, we declare like the psalmist says, that then I will go to the altar of God, to God my exceeding joy. And upon the lyre, I will praise you, O God, my God. Yes, Father God, you are the exceeding joy. All that is in heaven and on earth belongs to you. And because of this and more, you are our exceeding joy. You are our delight. And we come before you in prayer to exalt your name forever. We praise you, Lord, for your glorious name. For in your hand are both power and might. It is by your word that you make great or bring down. There is none higher than you and none more worthy of all of our praise this morning. Thank you for your beauty and the delight you took in making your creation. You have placed us in the midst of a wondrous and amazing world. You astound us with your creatures and with your imagination. The depth of your knowledge is limitless. And because of it, we find joy in learning and discovering new things. Thank you for the pleasures we are blessed to experience as a result of knowing and loving you. Thank you, Father, the God of our exceeding joy. All things come from you and are created by you. Even our joy and our delight are from your blessed hand. Forgive us for seeking joy in other sources than you. Pardon us for turning to things outside of you to seek what can be found only in you. You are the source of our joy. Yes, Father Lord. And in your presence, there is always pleasures forevermore. and we have come into your presence this morning. Lord, we ask if there be anything in our life that will hinder us this morning. We pray, Lord, that you will forgive us. Forgive us. Wash us clean with the blood of Jesus Christ, Lord. Wash us with the blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, Lord. Forgive us of our sin. And we pray, Father, Lord, that you will show us your wonders. Delight us with that which delights you, Lord. When we witness the things that make your heart glad, our hearts will become glad as well. Give us the pleasure of knowing you intimately, because in you we find our joy and our delight. Father, Lord, help us also to bring joy to other people we come into contact with. Make us, O Lord, to be a channel of joy, Lord. Let your joy radiate within us to outside, that other people will find joy in our presence as well, Lord. This morning, help us, Lord, to say kind and encouraging words and to always think on things that are pure. Thank you, Father, Lord. Thank you for what you have in store for us this morning. Hallelujah be to your name, Lord. We worship you. We adore you. In the name of Jesus, amen, amen. Let's go to our declaration this morning. Eliezer declaration. It is written, Jeremiah 21, verse 12. O house of David, thus says the Lord, execute justice each morning and deliver him who has been robbed from the hand of the oppressor. Let my fury go out like fire and burn so that no one can quench it because of the evil of your deeds. Let's read that again. And where David said, put your name there. It is written, Jeremiah 21:12, O house of Oyedele. Put your household there this morning. Thus says the Lord, execute justice each morning and deliver him who has been robbed from the hand of the oppressor. Lest my fury go out like fire and burn so that no one can quench it because of the evil of your deeds. This is a mandate. Therefore, because of this mandate this morning, pray that because I've received this mandate this morning, I take authority over this day in the name of Jesus Christ. I decree that all the elements of this day will cooperate with me. I decree that these elemental forces should refuse to cooperate with my enemies. I speak unto the sun, the moon, and the stars. They must not smite me. I put down every negative energy planning to operate against my life today. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and I'll be glad in it in the name of Jesus. I dismantle any power altering incantations to capture the day. I render such incantation and satanic prayer null and void. I retrieve the day out of their hands in the name of Jesus. Spirit of favor, counsel, might, and power, come upon me in the name of Jesus. I shall excel this day, and nothing shall defy me. I shall possess the gates of my enemies. The Lord shall anoint me with the oil of gladness above my fellows. The fire of the enemy shall not burn me. My ears shall hear good news, and I shall not hear the voice of the enemy. My future is secured in Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. Therefore, because of the mandate that we received this morning, let us pray that, Father, let any power storing my blessing in any tree, begin to release it. Wherever they store my blessing, wherever they store my children's blessing, in the name of Jesus, because the word of God says, in each morning, we should execute judgment. We should execute execute justice each morning. So therefore, this morning, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, any power, story my blessing, story my children blessing, in anywhere else, this morning, release it, release them, in the name of Jesus Christ, release them unto me, in the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. Let us pray that, my Lord, let not my enemies triumph over me, O Lord, O gracious Father. This morning I pray, let not my enemies triumph over me. Let not my enemies triumph over me, over my household. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, you give us the mandate this morning to execute justice each morning and deliver those who have been robbed from the hand of the oppressor. So, Father God, we do pray in the name of Jesus. We ask, let not the enemy triumph over us. In the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name, amen. Pray this morning. I clear my goods out of every satanic warehouse in the name of Jesus Christ. All that belong to me, all that belong to my children, I clear them out of the satanic warehouse this morning in the name of Jesus Christ, because we have received the mandate this morning to execute justice each morning and deliver him who has been robbed from the hand of the oppressor. This morning, every goods that have been stored in any satanic warehouse, we clear them out in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Pray that, Lord, let the angels that is bringing my blessing this morning receive overcoming divine assistance in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, you don't know the package that God has given to you, all the prayers that you have been praying. God hears and God answers, but there is a king of Persia, the prince of Persia, that is holding the angel this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. Pray this morning that, Father, let the angels that is bringing my blessing receive overcoming divine assistance this day in the name of Jesus Christ, because I know that you are the God that answers prayer. You heard us, O Lord, our Father. So this morning, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, let the angels that is bringing those blessings, Father, receive overcoming divine assistance in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. In the name of Jesus, I paralyze the power of the prince of the air upon my prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, begin this morning. I paralyze the power of the prince of the air upon my prayers. I paralyze you. I paralyze you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. In the name of Jesus, I decree. Because this morning, we have been received the mandate to execute justice each morning. So this morning, I decree in the name of Jesus that all satanic laughter at my life be turned to sorrow in the name of Jesus Christ. All satanic laughter at my life, at my children's life, be turned to sorrow in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, all satanic laughter at my life, at my children's life, at my ministry, at my career, in the name of Jesus, Father Lord, turn it to sorrow for them in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Let every mountain of hindrance to my prayers be melted by divine fire in the name of Jesus Christ. It will be like wax. When wax come in contact with fire, what happened? They met this morning. All satanic laughter at every mountain of hindrance to my prayer be melted by divine fire in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father Lord, let every mountain of hindrance to my prayers this morning receive the fire. Let it become a wax, O Lord, that we melt before the fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Let it be melted in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Pray that, Lord, let the displacing power of the Holy Spirit displace any darkness in my life and replace it with light in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, let the displacing power of the Holy Spirit displace any darkness in my life, any darkness in the life of my children, and replace it with light in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. cry out to the Lord our God this morning that, oh Lord, convert every failure in my life to success in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, you are the converter. Lord, you are the story changer. Convert every failure in my life to success. Convert every failure in my children's life to success, oh Lord our God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray that, oh Lord our Father, convert every frustration in my life to fulfillment in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, my Father, this morning I pray thee, Father Lord, convert every frustration in my life to fulfillment. Convert every frustration in the life of my children and any member of my household to fulfillment, oh Lord our God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray this morning that, Father, Lord, convert every rejection in my life to acceptance in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, mighty Father, because you are the story changer, with you there is nothing impossible. So Father Lord, this morning in my life, in the life of my children, I ask, oh Lord, convert every rejection in my life to acceptance in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Pray that, oh Lord my God, convert every pain in my life to pleasure in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord my Father, convert every pain in my life to pleasure in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Oh Lord, we're still in that conversion this morning in the name of Jesus, because you are the story changer. So Father Lord, convert every poverty in my life to blessing, whether it's a physical, material, or spiritual poverty. Lord God Almighty, convert every poverty in my life to blessing in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Still pray that, Father, convert every mistake in my life to perfection in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord my Father, convert every mistake in my life to perfection in the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name. Amen. You believe the Lord this morning as the healer? Then ask him this morning that, Father, convert every sickness in my life to health in the name of Jesus Christ, because your word say that you wish above all things that you prosper and be in good health, even as our soul prosper. So, Father God, convert every sickness in my life to health in the name of Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name. Amen. Because of the mandate that we received this morning, he said, O house of David, thus says the Lord, execute justice each morning and deliver him who has been robbed from the hand of the oppressor. Lest my fury go out like fire, a burn so that no one can quench. That means if we fail to execute justice this morning, that will be the result. But we are not disobedient child. We are obedient therefore this morning because of the mandate. Pray, I crush the head of every problem serpent in the name of Jesus Christ. I crush the head of every problem serpent in this family, in my life, in my children's life. This morning, stand. You are to execute justice this morning. I crush the head of every serpent in the name of Jesus Christ. Every serpent, every head serpent, every problem that is bringing any serpent, bringing problem into this household. You know serpent, subtle, deceitful. So when we're talking of serpent, we're just talking about the character. Just think about it. Manipulative. This morning, I crush the head of every manipulation in this household, in my life, in the life of my children, in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of deceit, I come against you, I crush your head in the name of Jesus Christ. I trample upon every problem serpent and scorpion in the name of Jesus Christ. Scorpion that stung, that bites you, sting you in the name of Jesus Christ. This morning, I execute justice and I crush the head of every serpent and scorpion in the name of Jesus, because we have been given the mandate even to trample upon them this morning. According to the mandate given by the word of the Lord, I trample upon every problem serpent and scorpion in the name of Jesus Christ. And if you know that problem that is still biting you this morning, mention that problem. I trample upon you. I trample upon you in the name of Jesus Christ. This morning, I bind and I paralyze the spirits and activities of the wasters upon my life, upon my children's life, in the name of Jesus Christ. This morning, according to the mandates given by the word of the Lord, that Saint Jeremiah 21 verse 12, O house of David, thus says the Lord, execute justice each morning and deliver him who has been robbed from the hand of the oppressor. Let my fury go out like fire and burn so that no one can quench it because of the evil of your deeds. This morning, I bind and I paralyze the spirits and activities of the wasters upon my life, upon my children's life, in the name of Jesus Christ, upon every member of my household this morning, in the name of Jesus, according to the mandate that has been given this morning, I bind and I paralyze the spirits and activities of the wasters upon my life, upon my children's life, upon my grandchildren, upon my son-in-law, my daughter-in-law. Oh, I bind you in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. I bind and I paralyze the spirits and activities of the devourer upon my life in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we're acting according to the mandate that you are giving to us this morning. You said it in your word that, O house of David, thus says the Lord, execute justice each morning and deliver him who has been robbed from the hand of the oppressor. So, Father, according to the mandate you have given, I bind and I paralyze the spirit and activities of the devourer upon my life, upon the life of my brothers and my sister, at the sound of my voice this morning. I bind and I paralyze the spirit and activities of the devourer upon our life, upon our children's life, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, mighty Father. Thank you, our Lord and our God, because we know you've heard our cry. Glory be to your name. As we go into your word, Lord, open our eyes, our hearts, oh Lord. Holy Spirit, illuminate us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. We're going to go to the word of God this morning, and we're reading Psalm 149. Hallelujah. We're there. Psalm 149. Let us listen, and we shall be blessed.
Psalm 149. Praise the Lord. Sing to the Lord a new song, his praise in the assembly of his faithful people. Let Israel rejoice in their Maker. Let the people of Zion be glad in their King. Let them praise his name with dancing and make music to him with timbrel and harp. For the Lord takes delight in his people. He crowns the humble with victory. Let his faithful people rejoice in this honor and sing for joy on their beds. May the praise of God be in their mouths, and a double-edged sword in their hands, to inflict vengeance on the nations and punishment on the peoples, to bind their kings with fetters, their nobles with shackles of iron, to carry out the sentence written against them. This is the glory of all his faithful people. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise,
praise him with
praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So this morning, we know finally we're heading there. Psalm 149. If you are reading it or listening to it, we see that there are some words in these Psalms. It's like party words. It's a big glad. Rejoice, dance, make melody, exult, sing for joy. This isn't a meditative, softly spoken psalm, a whisper on one's lips from the depth of his prayer closet. It's lamb dancing at a wedding. Can you just picture it? It's a parade through the streets. It's a voice at the top of your lungs, in a car with your best friend from high school. Can you just imagine? Picture back, return back, some of you, you know, when you get yourself into the car and you're singing, banging your head and rejoicing. It's dancing all night, then waking up singing for joy the next morning. What is the reason? What is the rationale for this riotous joy? It's because our Father takes delight in us. He takes pleasure in his people. He adorns the humble with salvation. There is time for sorry, for sin. There is time for repentance and sackcloth and ashes. There is a day for the withering of the heart. But this is not the day in these Psalms. Today is a head-banging hallelujah. Today is the day to turn up to the level of that music. Because the Lord inhabits the praise of his people. So the psalm says this. I titled this that the power of God's people. The power of God's people. If you read that verse 5 and 6, let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud on their bed. Let the high praises of God be in their mouths and in two-edged sword. First of all, we know that for some of us, to the Lord, praise to the Lord is one-dimensional. Praise involves singing a hymn or a worship chorus to the Lord in a place of worship at a designated time. Usually, this simply means in a church or on a Sunday morning. But praise that is birthed by the Spirit of God can be much more than just that. Psalm 149 calls for a wide range of praise. It begins by calling for a new song. Sing to the Lord a new song. His praise in the assembly of his faithful people. And it is my prayer this morning that the Lord will put a new song in our hearts to sing unto him. It seems like the Creator would like to hear something fresh and creative. That is so like him. After all, his mercies are new every morning. Now, I want us to get it clear. Don't get me wrong. There is a place for the tried and true and the old and familiar, but genuine praise is like fresh homemade bread. For those of us who do bakery, we know that smell. You know that sweetness when you eat fresh homemade bread, not the one bought in the store. It's best served warm from the oven. Stay worship invigorates no one. Secondly, our praise for the Lord can take a variety of form. He said, let Israel rejoice in their maker. Let the people of Zion be glad in their king. Let them praise his name with dancing and make music to him with timbre and harp. Spirit-initiated praise knows no bound and refuses to be confined to a church building. It is, after all, an outward expression of a thankful heart. There is a praise for joy where we find ourselves. Whether it's on the park bench, in a subway car, or as you stroll down the aisle or the grocery store, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You may ask the question, I ask you the question, is it possible to be God-focused when we are self-focused or self-conscious? How can we be worshippers throughout the week, throughout the day? How can we think about it? Father God, I pray this morning that you will renew in us a heart of praise. We want to lose ourselves for self-consciousness as we praise you. True worship is not about us, it's all about you. And we want to praise you with our whole being. Help us, Lord. Help us, Father God. See, the spirit of the first part of this psalm continues. He said, the saints are so happy in God's glory, and they sing aloud on their beds. Waking hour did not give enough time to express all their praise and joy unto God. So they must continue it on their beds. And this reminds us that though songs of praise are especially wonderful among the assemblies of God's people, as you have read it in verse 1, they should never be restricted to the assembly. It is a sacred and wonderful thing for the saints to sing aloud on their belts. Let the high praises of God be in their mouth. See, I'm talking about the power of God's people. He said, let the high praises of God be in their mouth and two-edged sword in their hand. God's people are pictured as ready for battle, equipped with two mighty weapons. Let's look at it. They bear the high praises of God. Their worship indicates their allegiance and the surrender to the God of every victory. A great victory was won for the people of God as they entered the battle with praise. We read it with Jehoshaphat in 2 Chronicles. Then the other part says, they bear a two-edged sword in their hand, demonstrating both the use of the practical weapons and means and in a spiritual sense. Reliance upon God's word, which is described as two-edged sword, in Revelation, and as even a sharper than any two-edged sword in Hebrew. We're talking of the word of God. As the sword of the Spirit, Ephesians tells us, a two-edged sword, where to use it. Their praise is not merely to be that one of chanting of words. It is also to be in the doing of His will. While the high praises of God are in their mouth, a two-edged sword is in their hand, with which they carry out His purposes among the people, the king and the nobles. And in this state of mind, the Lord will grant victory to His people, as He did to Nehemiah and his men, who walk with sword and trowel, while praying to the Lord, believing that our God will fight for us. You must believe that. Then the victory, the last part of the 7-9, the victory of God's people is to execute vengeance on the nations and punishment. Punishment on the people, to bind their kings with chains and their nobles with fetters of iron, to execute on them the written judgment. This honor have all His saints. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This honor, you see, it's an honor to execute vengeance of the nation. The power of praise and the word of God will ultimately see God's work accomplished among the nations. For those who persist in disobedience, it will be vengeance and punishment at the end of the age. Not even kings or nobles can escape this judgment to come. I know that in this immediate context of the psalmist, in some way Israel was to be the agent to execute vengeance. This means that their joyful praise had to connect itself to the radical obedience, even to God's difficult and costly commands. And as believers under the new covenant, we don't battle flesh and blood enemies, no. Yet, we have the responsibility to be not only worshippers, but warriors in a spiritual warfare that at times will be difficult and costly. We must know that. In a spiritual sense, we're to execute vengeance on everything that will oppose Jesus Christ in the work of His kingdom, in our lives, in the life of everyone that we encounter. That is a responsibility. That is the power of God's people. He said, dishonor have all his saints. In some way beyond our present comprehension, God will use his people in certain rights the wrong of this present age. Even if our participation is only as an audience to the righteous judgment of God, it will be an honor to all the saints. It's an honor. It's an honor. So first of all, let's realize we live under a new and better covenant with Jesus as our Lord and Savior. When he was arrested, Jesus told Peter to put away his sword. We'll do well when we heed that advice. The eager warmongers among us often need to take a chill pill. Jesus showed no tendency to war or harm revolt against the oppression of the Roman Empire. We're not asking you to go out now and start marching. No. But we have a battle to fight. And we urgently need a double-edged sword, brothers and sisters. Paul called it the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. So this morning, how effective are you in handling the word of God? How effective? You're still drinking the milk. How effective? Even that milk, how effective are you able? How effective are you in battling the spiritual forces and daily temptations arrayed against you? With the praises of God in your mouth and the word of the Spirit in your hand, are you propelling your way to victory in the daily ground of life? Are the joy and peace of God reigning in your life? James chapter 1 verse 12 says this, "Blessed is the one who perseveres under trial, because having stood the test, that person will receive the crown of life that the Lord has promised to those who love him." Are you developing competence in rightly using the word of God? What can you do? Ask yourself, think about it. What can you do to enhance your knowledge and application of God's word? What can you do? Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we want to grow in your love for your word, Father God. We want to grow in your love, in our love for your word. Help us to use it wisely to advance your kingdom. Help us, Lord Jesus, to gain free victory over dark spiritual forces. Help us, Lord Jesus. We cry out to you this morning. Help us to gain victory over dark spiritual forces that hinder us from studying your word. Help us, Lord. Yes, that verse 1 says, "Praise the Lord, sing to the Lord a new song, and his praise in the assembling of saints." You are amazing. Our God is amazing, God. Praise him this morning. Your goodness knows no end, O Lord. Your mercy are beyond measure. Your love abounds. We cannot help but praise your great name. We were a sinner, wretched and lost, but you found us and you restore us. While we are still sinning, you show your great love toward us. You have given us your Spirit to lead us and to guide us. And daily, day by day, you cleanse us. More and more, you conform us into the image of your Son, King Jesus. We have done nothing to deserve this great love, yet you pour it out all the more abundantly. Your salvation is strong and true. So this morning, Father, we declare all that we have is yours, Father. Will you ask him this morning, "Take my life and let it be"? wholly consecrated unto you, Lord God Almighty. Surrender yourself to him this morning. That, Lord, take my life and let it be. Let it be, Lord, wholly consecrated unto you. All that I have is yours. I am yours, Lord. I am yours. Hallelujah be to your name. Praise be to the God, our God, this morning. Praise him. Hallelujah. Father, we adore you this morning. We bless your name this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ. That verse 7 says, to execute vengeance. Before them, ask the Lord, equip me with the power of praise and arm me with your two-edged sword in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, equip me with the power of praise and arm me with your two-edged sword in the name of Jesus Christ. I want to be a student of the word of God. I want to go deeper in your word, Lord. Help me, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now that verse 7 again, I want us to go there. He said to execute vengeance upon the heathen and punishment upon the people, to bind their kings and chain and their nobles with fetters of iron. Pray that, Father God, let every demonic king working against my life be bound with chains in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, let every demonic king working against my life, against my children's life, be bound with chains in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, this morning, let every demonic king working against my life, against my household, be bound with chains in the name of Jesus Christ. Let every demonic noble be bound with fetters of iron in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, let every demonic kings, demonic noble, be bound with fetters of iron. Let them be bound with fetters of iron in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father Lord, this morning, you have given us the mandate to execute justice each morning. And so, Father, this morning, all we are asking, let every demonic king working against our life, against our family, be bound with chains. Let every demonic noble be bound with fetters of iron in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. We're going to shift our prayer focus now on our children. God of God, that God will give them song in their hearts, new song in the hearts of our children. This morning, I think I have a verse of the scripture, Psalm 118, verse 15. It says, shouts of joy and victory resound in the tents of the righteous. The Lord's right hand has done mighty things. Do you hear that? It says, verse 15, Psalm 118, sounds of joy and victory resound in the tent of the righteous. The Lord's right hand has done mighty things. So pray that, Lord, let the voice of rejoicing and salvation continually be heard in the tabernacle of my children in the name of Jesus Christ. Because, Father, Lord, your word said this morning, shout of joy and victory resound in the tent of the righteous, because the blood of Jesus Christ has made us to be righteous. Oh, Lord, let the voice of rejoicing and salvation continually be heard in the tabernacle of my children in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Father God, this morning we pray thee, Father God, for our children. Let the voice of rejoicing and salvation continually be heard in their tabernacle in the name of Jesus Christ. Pray that, Lord, before the end of this year, O Lord, put joy in the heart of my children and laughter in their mouth, that we provoke a new song in the name of Jesus Christ. Pray for your children this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord our God, before the end of this year, oh Lord, put joy in the heart of my children and laughter in their mouth, that we provoke a new song in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord our God, this morning we ask you, Lord, put joy before the end of this year. This is October 28th. Lord, before the end of this year, oh Lord our God, we ask you, put joy in the hearts of our children and laughter in their mouth, that you provoke a new song in the name of Jesus Christ. Pray that, Father Lord, remove the legs of my children from all ungodly journeys and remove their step from every satanic diversion in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Father Lord, remove the legs of my children, my grandchildren, from all ungodly journeys and remove their steps from every satanic diversion in the name of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, this morning I pray thee, O Lord my Father, remove the legs of my children from every satanic journey and remove their steps from every satanic diversion in the name of Jesus Christ. Whether the enemy likes it or not, pray that this month of October, because it has not ended, for my children is the month of new song. Begin to sing for joy in the name of Jesus Christ. Whether the enemies like it or not, this month, my children, it's your month of new song. Begin to sing for joy in the name of Jesus Christ. We're still in October 28th. And I say in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, whether the enemy likes it or not, this month is the month for our children to begin to sing their new song in the name of Jesus Christ. To begin to sing for joy in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, every enemy of joy preventing my children from singing a new song unto the Lord, your time is up. In the name of Jesus, die by fire. In the name of Jesus, every enemy of joy preventing my children from singing a new song unto the Lord, your time is up. In the name of Jesus Christ, die by fire. Die by fire in the name of Jesus. Every enemy of joy preventing my children from singing a new song this morning, be arrested in the name of Jesus Christ. Be arrested in the name of Jesus. Let us cry out to the Lord this morning, that Father Lord, put a new song of victory, prosperity, and advancement in the mouth of my children in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, put a new song of victory, prosperity, and advancement in the mouth of my children in the name of Jesus Christ. Make them glad, oh Lord. Make them rejoice, oh Lord. If they may have party, let it be a party of joy unto the Lord. Father God, let us pray that, Father, oh God, our Father, give key of outstanding success and uncommon achievement to our children, that we make them sing a new song this year, 2023. Father God, our Lord and our God, this morning, give key of outstanding success and uncommon achievement to my children, that we make them sing a new song this year in the name of Jesus Christ. Because with you, Lord, nothing is impossible. And those things that are impossible with men are possible with you. So, Father, this morning we pray for our children, young and old, O Lord, that, Father God, you will give key of outstanding success and uncommon achievement to these our children, that they will, that we make them sing a new song this year in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, pray, restore the captivity of my children in a miraculous way. Give them a new song. Let their mouth sing a new song. We're talking about song in the name of Jesus Christ this morning. That Father God, restore the captivity of my children in a miraculous way. Give them a new song. And let their mouth sing a new song, O Lord our God. Put song into their mouths of these our children. Some of them, you know what they are asking. You know the challenges that they are facing. They may not be talking to us as parents because they don't want us to be worried, to be in a fretting. But Father God, we are committing them into your hand this day, Lord God, our God. Because we know that you hear our cry, O God. So, Father, restore the captivity of our children in a miraculous way. And give them a new name. Give them a new name and let their mouth sing a new song, O Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. A new name. They know them as single. Oh, Father God, give them a new name as a married couple. They know them as not having children. Lord, give them a new name as children, mother, father of children. Give them a new name. They know them as no job. Ah, Father God, me give them a new name. A new name. To be CEO. To be manager. To be a supervisor. Give them a new name. A new name, O Lord. And let them sing a new song unto you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray this morning that my Father, confuse the enemies of my children and make their enemies stepping stones for their advancement in their life in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, Father God, confuse the enemies of my children and make their enemies stepping stones for their advancement in life in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Father God, this morning, every enemies of progress, every enemies of advancement, every enemies of breakthrough in the life of our children, Lord, this morning, confuse them. Confuse them and make those enemies stepping stones for the advancement in life of our children in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let us ask our Father this morning, that my Father, do the unusual and the unexpected in the life of my children, that will make them break forth into joy and sing a new song. We are talking not just ordinary song this morning, a new song, a new song. That Father, Lord, do the unusual and the unexpected in the lives of our children, that we make them break forth into joy and sing a new song, O Lord our God. This morning, we come together in the name of Jesus Christ. Do the unusual. That is impossible with man, Lord, do it. Do it the unusual in the life of these our children, that will make them break forth into joy and sing a new song in the name of Jesus Christ. And I want us to pray that every seed of witchcraft in the family of my children, withholding their season of joy, receive the thunder fire of God and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus Christ. Every seed of witchcraft in the family of my children, whether it's on the father's side, on the mother's side, in the name of Jesus, that is withholding their season of joy, receive the thunder fire of God and burn to ashes. Burn to ashes in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every seed of household witchcraft, envious witchcraft, territorial witchcraft, in the family of my children, we told them their season of joy. This morning, we cry against you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, receive the thunder fire of God and burn to ashes. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, I invoke, because we have been given the mandate, for those of you just joining us this morning, we have been given the mandate to execute justice each morning. Therefore, I invoke the wrath of God on all household witchcraft and household wickedness. Delay my children's day of joy and new song in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. Upon each household represented on this prayer platform and anyone at the sound of my voice, I invoke the wrath of God on all household witchcraft and household wickedness, delaying the joy, delaying our children's day of joy, a new song, in the name of Jesus Christ. Because we are to execute judgment. We read it in Psalm 149. This is the honor of the saints, to execute judgment upon them this morning, according to the word of the Lord. I invoke the wrath of God on all household, envious, territorial, witchcraft, withholding, delaying our children's day of joy, a new song, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray that every satanic prophecy from any demonic church, by any false prophets, in order to make witchcraft exchange of the virtues of my children, I cancel it with the blood of Jesus Christ. That is why we must be careful to what we listen to. For whom that prophet said this, they did what said this. Read your word, read the Bible. Every satanic prophecy from any demonic church by any false prophet in order to make witchcraft exchange of the virtues of my children, I cancel it with the blood of Jesus. I cancel it with the blood of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus. You are a prophet. God has made you. You are, because you are a priest and prophet unto the Lord this morning. Prophesy over your children. Let us prophesy over our children this morning. That I prophesy into the lives of my children, that they will not rejoice in bondage. They will not drink the water of affliction or eat the bread of sorrow, in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare unto you, if you have the picture of your children or your children, anything, to you see them this morning. Visualize them. Lay your hand upon them this morning. That you, my children, I prophesy into your life this morning. That you will not rejoice in bondage. You will not drink water of affliction or eat the bread of sorrow, in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus, I decree into your life, you, my children, that you will not live in shame. You will not die in shame. And you will not be numbered among the wasted, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Blessed be to your name. Glory be to your name, Father God. Hallelujah, Father. Honor and power be unto you, Lord God Almighty. We worship you. We adore you. Because, Father, Lord, you've had us. To you be the glory. To you be the honor. Blessed be to your name. Hallelujah. As we go this morning, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be and abide with us, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Thank you for coming. Don't forget to share with others. Let us be our brother's keeper. God bless you. Have a wonderful week.